Hello friends, welcome back to our channel, You Next Officer. We are here to continue our series of discussion of UPSC CSE Mains Sociology daily one question of previous year mains, and will provide you the model answer. And this model answer will be provided in our Telegram channel. Do subscribe, share, like our channel, guys. Let's take our today's question. So, our question, day three question is intellectual sources for the rise of sociology. So, question right, this is a 2011 or 2010 question, right? So, I would like to highlight one more thing, that here we are discussing not all about the whole sociology, whole concept, but the thing is that I am focusing on how to structure the question. This is important. If you have the knowledge, it's well and good. If you are not having the knowledge about a particular topic, so let's discuss, right? The question is, write a short note on the intellectual sources for the rise of sociology. The question says, what all the intellectual forces are responsible for the rise of sociology? So, we have to start, this is the question, and we have to start it with the introduction part, right? So the introduction, here it is. So emergence of sociology can be traced to that period of European history which saw the tremendous change in the thinking pattern, rise of question on the state and status quo, right? See, the thing is that I'll explain you one thing, that is, this is modernity, industrial revolution, French revolution came. All these gave, right, what is because of these all happened, right, is because of the social changes plus what it is important, intellectual changes. Why? Because of the intellect, because of the thinker like Rousseau, Montesquieu, right? They influence what? They influence the sociology as a whole. So as the definition goes, emergence of sociology can be traced to that period of European history which saw the social changes, right? And in this, what happens in this era, that everyone, that is intellectuals influence the common man, right? Intellectual influence the common man, and common man started asking question, right? See, here we go, like that, these were the intellectuals, and they influenced the common man, and their common man started asking question, right, questioning, what is important in this intellectual era, questioning is important, why Pope has all the power, he or she, we can take Pope not as an individual, rather he is an institution himself, right? People started questioning, right? So, we'll move on to the next slide. See, some of you were asking about to explain it, explain in Hindi as well. So, we'll definitely, at the conclusion, we'll explain the whole part, whole topic in Hindi as well, right? Okay, next we'll, the second paragraph of this is influence of enlightenment thinkers. Like enlightenment thinker, who were they? Montesquieu. He said about in his book, he advocated for the separation of power, means separate the power of the Pope. See, now Pope was having every power. He is a Pope, he is an institution, I already told you, he is an institution, right? See, Montesquieu questioned it, what? Advocated Montesquieu in his book, spirit of law advocated for the separation of power. Now Pope has, see, earlier Pope is having all the power. What kind of power? Executive power, implementation, legislative power and financial power, right? Now Montesquieu gave what? The spirit of law. So what it is? This separation of power. Now the legislature should be there according to the Montesquieu. Executive should be there, right? Executive like officers, right? Minister, the separation of power is very important concept, right? So because of the question was asking about the intellectual sources, right? The question was asking what? Intellectual sources. The same goes with that. So he is an intellectual. He is an intellectual, Montesquieu. The spirit of law, separation of power. And what it is? The authority. The Rousseau advocated the idea, gave the idea of a people right to choose their sovereign power. Now everything is started questioning, right? Question is very important. In this era, the question has started, emerged, right? Next is the persecution of sociology also help in the development of sociology, right? See, persecution means is sociology develop होने से पहले कौन से subjects थे, ठीक है? उन पर discussion होना चाहिए. So, philosophy of history, evolution of biology, these were the early things, means early subjects developed, right? Next, Herbert Spencer, evolution of biology. Next, we have the use of social survey. See, we need to understand how these subjects, means persecutor of sociology means how these subject means history, how history influence sociology, right? How evolution of biology influence this. See, Herbert Spencer, okay? So you have to write it. See, sociologist with the influence of these statistical methods like social survey emerged. So statistical tools developed ho gaye, right? Next we have the emergence of new theories, that is functionalist. See, functionalists study the coordination and solidarity of the society and study the institution function in a systematic order, right? So we need to understand. See, I had already discussed about these things with you, that is functionalist. There is a prism, right? No, this is a kind of a prism. And this is a society. And there are the theorists. They view the society, functionalist view the society as a good order, right? Everything is good and the society is living in a coordination, right? Next, we have the Marxist approach. This Marxist says everything is in the capitalist society, everything is in the conflict. Everything is in the conflict because of modernity, because of industrial revolution, because of French Revolution, right? Okay. Next, and he advocated for the communist form of society. He advocated for the to establish a communist form of society. Next, at the end, you have to discuss about the advent of enlightenment, means this is a conclusion part, right? This is a conclusion part. Advent of enlightenment, evolution of science, Copernican revolution, biology and social welfare, right? So, now I'm explaining you in the Hindi. Everything, that is, we have to start it with the मीन्स हमें स्टार्ट करना है सोशोलॉजी कैसे इंटेलेक्चुअल सोशोलॉजी कैसे इंटेलेक्चुअल सोर्स बनी राइट, कैसे उसका इमरजेंस हुआ, और मॉन्टेस्क्यू इसके जो मॉन्टेस्क्यू हैं, रूसो हैं, उन्होंने कैसे अलग अलग थॉट प्रोसेस दिए जिससे एक इंटेलेक्चुअल आइडियाज़ डेवलप हुआ, राइट. दिस वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द इंटेलेक्चुअल आइडियाज़ वर डेवलप विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इंटेलेक्चुअल आइडियाज़ डेवलप, इंटेलेक्चुअल आइडियाज़ डेवलप्ड, राइट. नेक्स्ट, philosophy of history, how history contributed to the sociology, how history contributed in the development of sociology, how biology contributed, these were the statistical method, kaise statistical method ne develop kiye. Next we have the new theorist, how theorist contributed in the development of sociology, these were the intellectual forces, right, intellectual forces, right. नेक्स्ट मार्क्सिस्ट अप्रोच एंड फाइनली कंक्लूजन. सो कंक्लूजन सेज विद द एडवेंट ऑफ एनलाइटमेंट, एवोल्यूशन ऑफ साइंस, कॉपरनिकन रेवोल्यूशन ऑफ बायोलॉजी एंड सोशल वेलफेयर. सो इट सेज दैट बिकॉज ऑफ द एनलाइटमेंट, बिकॉज ऑफ द एवोल्यूशन, दीज वर दे गेव द आइडियाज, न्यू आइडियाज, उन्होंने नए आइडियाज दिए सोसाइटी में, राइट, दैट न्यू आइडियाज, न्यू इंटेलेक्चुअल डेवलपमेंट. And that will definitely going to help the society and sociology as a whole to emerge as a new body of knowledge. Sociology emerged as a new body of knowledge. Okay. So thank you very much, guys. I'm done with this day 3 initiative. So please suggest whatever changes you want me to incorporate. You want me to how I can help you more. So let me know in the comment section, and do subscribe to our channel and like, comment. Thank you very much. Thank you guys. Thank you.